Zamp Solar Packages, and Zantrax Inverter. When we originally designed the Oliver Travel Trailer, we wanted to make it practical for every camping style. If you plan to camp at campsites with water and power connections, our base model will work very well for you. However, if you plan to get off the beaten path and still use most of the functions and components without being hooked up to shore power, you will probably want to add some options to make your off-grid camping experience exceptional. Our most popular add-on for boondocking is our Zamp Solar Package, usually paired with our AGM battery upgrades and Zantrax Inverter. The solar package is installed at the factory and consists of Zamp Solar roof-mounted panels and Zamp Solar 30-amp charge controller. It is also designed to be very easy to use. As long as the sun is out, you'll get a free source of energy that is clean and quiet. For the solar package to work, the solar panels convert the photons from the sun's rays into electrons of direct current electricity. The charge controller regulates the amount of current and voltage that is sent to the batteries in different automated stages to prevent them from being overcharged, extending the life of your batteries. The solar panels are roof-mounted on both Legacy Elite and Legacy Elite 2 models. If you order the Legacy Elite, it will have two 115-watt panels, giving you a total of 230 watts of solar charging. The Legacy Elite 2 has two 170-watt panels for a total of 340 watts. Depending on the availability of the sun and how you use your trailer, these large arrays of solar panels will keep your batteries charged for days or weeks when camping off-grid. The Zamp Solar ZS30A charge controller is a PWM, or pulse width modulation charge controller, and it is capable of handling up to 30 amps of current and 510 watts of power. Depending on the Oliver model you have purchased, you will find the charge controller mounted on either the rear upper cabinet or above the radio on the interior street side of the trailer. Other than parking your travel trailer in the sun, there's really nothing you have to do to the charge controller for it to work properly. The amp volt button on the top right allows you to easily cycle the digital LCD to display the battery voltage, charging current, charging capacity, and battery temperature. The battery voltage displays the current voltage that your batteries are charging at. The charging current displays the voltage level going from your solar panels to your batteries. The charging capacity displays the total amp hours that have been harvested from the solar panels for the current day. The battery type button is the only button that you can actually change a setting in. It simply allows you to change the battery type that you have installed on your Ollie. This will be configured during installation at the factory and is typically not changed. Many PWM charge controllers have a three-stage charging algorithm that includes the standard bulk, absorption, and floating stages. The Zamp ZS30A also includes an equalization stage and a soft charge stage, not found on most other PWM charge controllers. The soft charge stage softly ramps the battery voltage up to 10 volts after batteries have been over-discharged. The voltage generated during the soft charge stage varies between 3 and 10 volts. The bulk charging stage maximizes current until the batteries rise to the absorption level. The voltage is between 10 and 14 volts during this stage. About 85% of battery charging takes place during the bulk stage. The absorption charging stage supplies a constant voltage charge when the battery is over 85%. During this stage, 14.4 to 14.7 volts is generated depending on the type of batteries you use. Since the batteries are approaching full at this stage and the internal resistance or pushback is high, this stage takes the longest to complete. The equalization stage is for wet cell batteries and is used to remove sulfation that occurs when batteries are undercharged and to bring internal battery cells to equal states. This stage is performed every 28 days using a higher voltage of 15.5 volts and times out at 2 hours. You typically do not want to run equalization charge stages on AGM batteries, but Lifeline says it's safe to run equalization as a recovery tool for their AGM batteries. If you have a Legacy Elite model with Lifeline AGM batteries and notice the batteries are not fully charging, you can try to recover the batteries by changing the battery type to wet to activate the equalization stage of the charge controller. For Legacy Elite 2 models equipped with Trojan AGM batteries, you will want to keep the battery type on AGM at all times. The floating charge stage, a trickle charge, is a maintaining stage that uses lower voltage when batteries are charged to more than 13.6 volts. On the display panel, you'll also see six colored LED lights that indicate charging status and current condition of the batteries. The three charging status lights on the left let you know if your battery charging is taking place or if the unit is providing a float charge when batteries are fully charged. The red LED on the left indicates the unit is on. During a bulk, absorption, or equalization charging stage, you will see the second LED from the left illuminated in blue. If the controller is in a soft charge stage, the blue LED will be flashing on and off. If the blue charging light is off and you see the third indicator light from the left illuminated in green, the battery is fully charged and is being maintained with a float charge. The three battery condition LED lights on the right indicate roughly a 25%, 50%, and 75% charge. The green 75% charged LED on the left of the battery condition group will also be illuminated during the bulk or absorption charge stage. If you have added one of the ZAMP solar packages to your Ollie, you'll also find a ZAMP solar portable port located on the street side of your travel trailer next to the battery compartment. The portable solar kits are ideal when you are camping in areas that have overhanging trees that block the sun from the roof-mounted panels. The portable port connects to your portable solar panels directly to the batteries and is not controlled by the main onboard charge controller. The portable solar kits come equipped with their own charge controller. If you're interested in adding additional solar charging to your Ollie, the ZAMP Solar Portable Solar Kits are available in 45, 90, 140, 180, and 230-watt kits and can be purchased through all of our travel trailers or any of their dealers across North America. To get the most out of your solar package, we highly recommend upgrading to one of our AGM battery options. The advantage of the 6-volt AGM batteries include having a lower discharge rate when not in use, deeper depth of discharge, charging up to 5 times faster than flooded batteries, spill-proof, vibration-resistant, maintenance-free, and perform better in cold temperatures. If you have purchased our Xantrex inverter option, it will also allow you to use the 120-volt outlets on your travel trailer from your 12-volt battery system, and it will be pre-installed at the factory, located under the street side access panel below the seat cushions or bedding. The Xantrex ProWatt SW2000 inverter provides a true sine wave AC output of 1800 continuous watts and is capable of running your microwave or other personal appliances off your 12-volt battery system. When using the inverter, you will have limited amp output, depending on the amp draw of the 120-volt components and personal items you are using, you may experience some items do not work properly. If you experience some components not working properly, you may need to turn off less important power-consuming components or appliances. The inverter is also GFCI protected. If you are unable to turn on any 120-volt appliances, it is likely you will need to reset the GFCI. Locate the inverter under the access panel on the street side of your trailer and reset the switch when necessary. Due to a large amount of energy used by your AC, you will not be able to power it using the inverter and 12-volt battery system. If you plan to operate your AC when boondocking, you will need to bring a generator with you. If you have questions about operating the solar charge controller, inverter, or other components, see the component manuals supplied to you at delivery or view them online in Oliver University.